Yeah, here we go. This is a really good one.
Hi everybody, my name is Meaghan Anderson and I'm a field agronomist for Iowa State University Extension and Outreach. And as we approach spring, one of the most important things when we're out scouting is looking for what weeds are coming up in our crop fields. And when it comes to seedling ID, it's not just as simple as often looking at plants and saying, yeah, I know exactly what species that is. When these plants are really small like this, we gotta be able to look at the details of those species to be able to differentiate between them. And so I'll talk about some traits today that are gonna be important for identifying between species. So the first trait that we always look for on broadleaf plants is we look for the cotyledons. So that's the first set of leaves, we call them the seed leaves, that come out on the plants. And so you can see here, here's the two cotyledons on this plant, and right here, here are the cotyledons on this plant. And so you can always tell because they're going to be the lowest attached leaves on the plant. And it's important to look for these to start with because sometimes you can tell what species, or at least narrow down what species you're looking at based on the shape or the size of those cotyledons. So for example, this is a sunflower, and sunflowers have basically like a round or an oval shaped cotyledon, whereas we have a cocklebur right here. And cocklebur has these really, really long strap-shaped cotyledons. And if you just looked at these first leaves on the cocklebur and the first leaves on the sunflower, they would look really pretty similar. But the fact that we have those cotyledons allows us to differentiate between the two of them. The next thing you might look for is the leaf arrangement on the plants. And so seedling plants, as long as they are starting to develop those next leaves past the cotyledons, you can get an idea as to what leaf arrangement the species has. So in this case, on this sunflower, you could see that those two leaves are exactly the same size. And so they're being produced at the same node on the plant at the same rate. And so that's got an opposite leaf arrangement. Whereas if we look at a plant like this, we can see the two cotyledons here. And then we see that this is a big leaf, and then the next leaf is a really tiny leaf. And so that shows us that those leaves are gonna be alternate. So they're not being produced at the exact same rate. They're gonna be at different places on the stem when it starts to elongate. One of the other things that we might look for is trying to see how much hair a plant has, where that hair is located, and that can often help us differentiate between species as well. So like if we look at these two species, we can see the cotyledons actually, so those first leaves right here and right here, are really similar in shape, and they're not all that different in size either. And so something that we might look for on these plants to help determine what species they are is where they have hair and maybe how much hair they have. And so if we can get an up close look at these with something like a hand lens, they both have hairy stems, but actually this plant here has really densely hairy or pubescent leaves, and they're really soft. But if we look over at this species, the leaves are actually kind of shiny. And if we look at them under a hand lens, they maybe have a few hairs on them, but they're mostly gonna be glabrous. And so that can help us differentiate between this really fuzzy plant, velvet leaf, and this species over here that has a lot less hair, prickly cyta. So there are a lot of different traits that we might look for, but certainly the cotyledon shape, size, the arrangement of the leaves on the plant, and whether or not it has hair and where that hair is, are three important characteristics that we would look for on seedlings to ID them.